George Turner is a dynamic, ball-playing hooker of the sort Townsend likes. Peak copyright Alastair Ross Novante photography. In hindsight, it's perhaps not all that surprising that Scotland have named 10 uncapped players for their upcoming autumn international squad. Gregor Townsend and the Toonie Tombola style of selection has taken the leap from domestic rugby to international, while Scotland's PR team went into overdrive this week with talk of digging up every rock from Aberystwyth to Zenna in the search for Scottish qualified players. Townsend even acknowledged this when during the selection press conference he said, "Come on then, let's hear how many of you had those names in your squad." So, without further ado, in the immortal words of Cilla Black, number one, "What's your name and where do you come from?" Jamie Barty, a call up for the stocky young loosehead, is well deserved given the amount of faith that new Glasgow Warriors coach Dave Rennie has shown in him and the performances that he has put in that time. There aren't many loose head options in Scotland at the moment, but Barty has taken his opportunity in both hands, and the 24-year-old will hope he learn a lot in the Scotland camp. He featured solely for Melrose over the last two seasons, bar six games for Glasgow last year during the international windows, and only signed pro terms over the summer, but has played in every Glasgow game this season, starting most of them. Phil Burley, it's hard to think that 31-year-old Burley would have been selected for the squad if all of Scotland's available centres were fit and if Adam Hastings had been given more game time, but the Edinburgh playmaker is not without his merits. Any player that plays consistently in Alan Solomon's squad deserves a look at, and if Pete Horn or any of the starting centres become crocked, he could find himself in the Matt Kay squad. He qualified on residency during the summer after joining from Highlanders in 2014 and could become our latest kilted Kiwi. Scott Cummings, another player that has grasped with both hands the regular rugby that Dave Rennie has given him. Cummings definitely deserves to be in the squad. With Johnny Gray out injured earlier this season, Rennie has given 20-year-old EDP graduate Cummings chance after chance, and he looks like a veteran on the pitch. A hard-running, soft-handed modern lock, Cummings has the attributes needed for the international stage, and Townsend may well be tempted to put him on the bench for the Samoa match. If not, the experience of training with Scotland will do him the world of good. Nathan Fowlace, a curious one, given Edinburgh's inconsistency this year and the fact coach Richard Cockerell still seems unsure as to who his first-choice scrum half is. Tooney said that although Sam Hidalgo, Klein, Ben Vellicott, Scottish qualified, and Scott Steele, Dumfriesbourne have all impressed us in recent weeks, Nathan's passing accuracy is something we look for in our nines and means he is more suited to the rugby we aspire to play. A former England U20 player, Fowles has featured sporadically for the capital side since an initial three-month loan from Sale Sharks in 2015 led to a contract. He qualifies for Scotland through a Scottish-born grandparent. Luke Hamilton, surprisingly, the Wales Online website did not have a on meltdown when the former Wales U20 player was selected, with many people actually being quite gracious and wishing that Warren Gatland had looked at him. Which worries me. Nevertheless, the Leicester Tigers' back row has had a storming start to the season after spending 2 years hardening his nose in France with Egan. Powerful with ball in hand and in defence, 25-year-old Hamilton can play anywhere in the back row, and Townsend may well cap him to ensure he qualifies solely for Scotland. His father is from Stirling until his dying day. Despite being born in Pembrokeshire and playing for Wales U20s, this was pressed even Shingler madness, so the fact that he didn't play against France U20s means that help's not tied to Wales. Chris Harry's a product of the Newcastle Falcons Academy. Tooney stated that he was tempted to take him on tour over the summer but decided against it. Injuries may well have forced his hand now, and the centre wing could get a chance without a clear choice to partner Hugh Jones if Dunbar isn't fit. The fast, rangy centre has been critical to a Newcastle side that has been improving steadily for a couple of seasons now, playing a brand of rugby similar to Scotland's. He qualifies through a Scottish grandparent and may be another player that Tooney caps in case Eddie Jones is sniffing around. Daryl Muffo, Alan Dell, Alistair Dickinson and Gordy Reid are injured. Alan Jacobson refuses to come out of retirement, and seemingly nobody likes Ryan Grant anymore, so Scotland have called up Edinburgh prop Daryl Muffo. The loosehead has started just 3 league games this season, and his inclusion may have raised a few eyebrows, although they may have dropped again once people realise Scotland's prop injury list is longer than the list of people who don't like Andy Robinson. The 27-year-old Londoner signed for Edinburgh in the summer on a 1-year deal after spells with Bath, London Welsh and Harlequins, and has an Ayrshire-born mother. Byron McGuigan having failed to make the grade at Glasgow when younger, and injury hit while at Exeter Chiefs, Namibian-born McGuigan is finally showing the promise that many top coaches have seen in him now that he's at Sale Sharks. The winger is the top scorer in the English Premiership and even Scott Johnson would have been hard-pressed to ignore his form. With Tommy Seymour almost guaranteed on one wing, his clinical finishing may see him rise above Dougie Fife in the pecking order but behind Lee Jones, who has history with Tooney. He has Scotland Sevens and Scotland A experience and qualified for them through his Glaswegian mother. Jamie Ritchie. While all the talk may be on the new Scottish qualified players, it is nice to see people like Ritchie come through the Edinburgh ranks and into the international fold. The 21-year-old back row has continually impressed since making his debut 3 years ago, and it has always been a case of when, not if, he will be selected by Scotland. He is one of the first names on Cockerill's team sheet and has played every match this season, bar two, alongside King Magnus and Cornell Dupreez in an abrasive back row. Like Hamilton, HES played across the back row and could be useful from the bench. George Turner, another of Rennie's young tight five renegades. Turner joined Glasgow on a one-year loan this summer after making just one start in four infuriating seasons at Edinburgh and spending a short amount of time at London Scottish. His doggedness and modern style of play is something that obviously impresses Townsend, who took him on the summer tour, although didn't play him. The 25-year-old Stuart Melvillian has flourished thanks to regular rugby and with Ross Ford surely coming to the end of his 103-year stint as hooker, could get a chance to impress against Samoa, either off the bench or coming on for Stuart McKinnelly. Tags. Byron McGuigan, Chris Harris, Daryl Marfo, George Turner, Jamie Barty, Jamie Ritchie, Luke Hamilton, Nathan Fowles, Phil Burley, Scott Cummings. Follow Callum on Twitter at C_Gillen.